Welcome to the Cleveland Photographic Society's first People in Pictorial Competition of the 2021 Club Year. Let's start out the evening with our president, Mike Kopkus, with some general announcements.
I've been waiting 6 weeks to do that, so we're opening the meeting with the normal cowbell. I'd like to add my welcome to all of you. We are currently starting our virtual meetings, and for now they're being taped, but at some point soon we hope to be streaming them live, so you'll be able to tune in at 7:30 on Friday and see them live. If there are any visitors that are watching this presentation, normally we would have you introduce yourself. Obviously we can't do that, but please know that you are very welcome and we invite you to come back on following Fridays. And if you're interested in joining the club, please contact us through our calendar. And speaking of the calendar, I want to talk about some upcoming events. First of all, on July 15th, that will be the deadline for our next competition, which is Nature and Pictorial. As you know, the competitions this year will be digital, and so we have a deadline about a week and a half before. So on July 17th, we have a speaker. Coleman Rosenberg, a member of our club, will talk about impact on and your photographs. The July 19th Rubber Ducks baseball field trip has been canceled, and there have been a few other cancellations due to the COVID-19. Mansfield Reformatory, the Air Show, and the September's Back to the Wild have all been canceled at this point. We have added some new field trips, though, so you should be aware of those. July 25th, Queenswright Colonies field trip. On August 18th, Sunset in the Flats. And on August 22nd, Stone Garden Farms. All of these activities are outdoors, and they allow room for social distancing. And they're free and open to everyone. We do ask you to wear masks and maintain social distancing, though, as best you can. July 24th, 2 weeks from tonight, we have our Nature and Pictorial competition. I also want to point out the CPS Photo Challenge. It's a great opportunity to continue to use your cameras. Every 2 weeks, we introduce a brand new topic, and we ask you to take pictures for that topic during those 2 weeks. The complete rules for the CPS Photo Challenge are on the website, so please feel free to check that out. There are also some YouTube videos about how to sign up for Flickr, because you do need a Flickr account to do that. So please check the calendar and the website for more information on all of these items. So as we said, tonight is our first competition of the year, and for purposes of introducing the competitions, I want to turn it over to our competitions chair, Bill Keaton. Bill?
Hello all. Welcome to the very first competition of the competition year. And during these chaotic times, we've had almost 100 photographs entered this time. So considering circumstances, that's a pretty good turnout. Thank you for that. I want to bring up, since all the competitions this year are digital submissions, all the links are active for the entire year. You will notice that some of the competitions, half of them, are designated print competitions, even though you will be submitting digitally. If you read about the special awards, you'll see that some of them apply to pictorial digital, some to pictorial print, and that's the reason we have to designate it this way. Our special awards at the end of the year will remain the same. Our next competition is the nature competition in 2 weeks. I just wanted to bring up, since we are doing everything by digital submission, and the judges are putting comments on the judging site that allows us to go outside the geographic area to find new judges. And this coming nature competition, there will be three judges that are new to judging CPS competitions. So you might want to get some submissions in to hear their critiques and remarks. With that, I will hand things over to the competition people chair, Eric Wethington, and he will introduce to you the judges for the night.
Welcome again to the First People competition for the year. My name is Eric, and I'm going to introduce the judges for the night. First judge is Wendy Hess. She's assistant creator at the Akron Art Museum. She has coordinated traveling shows organized by other institutions. Run a 501c3 that acquired assistive equipment for special needs students. Has written a number of grants. Has edited and written for script-type publications. Is a regular visitor to the galleries and museums in Northeast Ohio and has two children and helps care for her ailing senior parents. Second judge for the night is Ray Hoser. He's a member of PPA, PPO, and the Ohio Society of Professional Photographers. He is the past president of the Certified Professional Photographers of Ohio and the Society of Northern Ohio Professional Photographers, has taught more than 30 professional seminars, Professional Photographers of America Craftsman degree, and has received well over 100 awards in local, national, and international competitions. And the last one for the night is Mark Nowak. He's a professional photographer based in Elyria. He shoots simple, classic photographic portraits. He creates customized portraits of individuals, seniors, and families. He's a past president of the Erie Shores Photography Club. Teaches a photography class to those starting out or with a new camera. As a longtime judge for the Cleveland Photographic Society. The judges are not here tonight. We have several CPS members that are reading their comments live, and we are all practicing social distancing inside the club room. Everybody's like a couple rows apart from each other. And I think that's all we needed to do for me. So let's get the competition started.
Okay. Thanks to all of our judges, and thanks to all of our readers here this evening. For the three judges, the part of Wendy Hess will be played by our own Lori Culp. The part of Ray Hoser will be played by Eric Wethington, and the part of Mark Nowak will be played by Chuck Fitzgerald. So you may recognize the voices, but they are not those of our actual judges. So this is our first People in Pictorial competition of the year. Our club year runs from June through May, so this will be our first actual competition of any kind, and also our first virtual competition. So things are a little rough. Please bear with us. We're still learning as we go. Okay, we'll start this evening with the people competition, and the first image is. Will be addressed by, I believe, who's our first person? Ray. Go ahead, Ray.
Ray says, interesting lighting on the face the photographer used, but I would like to have seen more separation from the background. I love the S-curve that is going on here.
Okay, this image is Addie by Margaret Brady. Total score, 21 points. Second image.
Wendy says, a very solid, thoughtful portrait and profile. The viewer is left wondering what the child is looking at and what he is thinking.
The image is by Richard Ader. The image title is Amish Boy 1. Total score, 22 points.
Mark says, okay, the first thing that jumps out of this image to me is the background. It's distracting from the young man. I'm not sure what the background is, but you've got a giant nut in the upper left-hand corner, and you've got some kind of structure to the right side. This is really distracting from your subject. If you're going out to festivals and events that you know you're going to be photographing people, then invest in a 5-in-1 reflector kit. One of the items in this kit is a diffuser. You can put it behind the sun in your subject. That will even out the light. You can also use the reflector to fill in shadows on your subject. Also, I would drop the hat down just above the band. I find that you either include the entire hat or leave just enough of the hat in the image to know that there's one there and that it's part of the character. I love that this image is absolutely tack sharp, and those eyelashes on his face is just what it should be tack sharp. Personally, I'd like to see a little bit more interaction between the subject and the photographer. That creates a bond or interaction between the subject and the photographer. That'll come across in your image. So take your time and work your subject and look at every part of the image. You'll end up with a much better image.
Images by Richard Ader. The title is Amish Boy 2, and the score is 21 points.
Ray says, nice use of color and composition is done well. Very good posing of the hand and feathering of the fingers. Makes me want to know what she is thinking.
Images by Betsy Gianda. Title is Ariana. Total score, 21 points.
Wendy says, nicely done baby portrait with great detail. I'd like to see it more tightly cropped on the sides and tilted up a bit on the right-hand side. Makes me think a bit of Ann Getty's work.
Images by Deb Zimmerman. The title is Baby Mouse Alex. The total points are 22.
Mark says, okay, Ansel Adams said that there are two people in every image, one being the photographer and the other one the viewer. So right now I'm trying to figure out what photography wants me to take from viewing in his or her image. I'm not sure why the chain is in the picture. I don't see the connection between the chain and the subject. You could crop this a few inches below his hand. I do see a connection between the paper up in the upper left-hand corner with writing on it. I have a feeling that this is part of the story there. I think the exposure overall is good. I would like to see a little bit more detail in the shirt. That would show his arm, then his hand would be attached to something. Also, tone down the highlights on the subject's right side. I know it's not always easy, but a good thing to always keep in mind is that what your background is doing, is it accentuating or is it distracting from your subject? I like that there's some subtle motion in the image. What is the old man thinking? Why is he where he's at?
The image is by Rick Carell. The image title is Contemplation. 23 points, honorable mention.
Ray says, more of a candid photograph. Lighting is flat on the girl's face. The image does tell a story of a child and her dog.
Images by Robert Boyle. Title is Girl Meets Dog. Total points, 19.
Wendy says, this portrait manages to be simultaneously powerful and lovely. The photographer has done an excellent job of capturing every detail and bit of texture while effectively using lighting to put the emphasis on the prime features of the face. Black and white work well with the subject's serious demeanor and weathered face. The only thing I could nitpick about is the lack of contrast of the fabric behind the chin and lips, but overall, I love this piece.
Images by Bill Keaton. Title is Guatemala Woman. Total points, 26 points, first place.
Mark has this to say. This looks like a fun image, not only to view, but it also a fun image to create. It's a very creative, and I love the lighting and the action in this image. It looks like the photographer used red and blue gels to create a different feel for this image, and it worked. I think I might have the musicians interact with each other rather than the camera at this point in time. That would create a bond between the two of them playing the music.
Images by Ronald Wilson. Title is Hot Girl Band 5. Total points, 22.
Ray says, like the use of color to bring the model out from the background. The lighting's a bit harsh, but it does work in this case, I think.
Images by Mike Kopkis. Title is Lady of Spain. 22 points.
Wendy says, a subtle, pleasing portrait with a beautiful composition. I'd like to see a bit more contrast. The overwhelmingly paler colors flatten the image out a bit.
The image is by Jackie Sieski. Title is Mother's Day 2020. 22 points.
Mark says, sometimes we just need to have fun with the cameras. This photographer got a bit too close to the snake. The snake hurt to find out if Nikon's verse top of people said they were. It seems to be a bit out of focus. Something like this is where it is your main subject. It has to be tack sharp. Something else to keep in mind is your background. Make sure your backgrounds are not cluttered or distracting from your subject. Make sure your backgrounds are not cluttered or distract from your subject.
This image is by Dennis Wirt. It's called Ready for My Close-Up. 21 points.
Ray says, love the photograph. Nice soft image, yet very sharp. Great soft lighting and use of color. The background was handled very well. It's a winner to me.
This image is by Susan Bestel. The title is Sisters. 26 points, first place.
Wendy says, really well composed portrait with bonus points for being brave enough to incorporate a moving fidget spinner. The composition is bold and the close cropping works well. I'd be curious to see how this one looks in color.
The image is by Dave Siborik. The title is Spinner, 22 points.
Mark says, what a cute little girl. The look on her face makes me wonder what she's thinking. When we were doing images like this one, we see the situation and think, wow, what a great pick. We need to take a few seconds and work the image. Bring her right arm around to her knee so it doesn't look cropped off. Swing her a bit to the left. Then you as a photographer move to your right. That would change the background and get rid of the pole and the bright spot in the upper right-hand corner. The few moments it takes to do this will result in a very pleasing image.
The image is by Kim Wasileski. The title is Sweet Caroline. Total 20 points.
Ray says, very interesting photograph. Makes you think on what you're looking at first. Glad the photographer did it in black and white with tone quality. Placement is nice with room for the image.
Images by Darla Zajac. The title is The Dragon Lights Veil Dancer. 21 points.
Wendy says, an extremely nice portrait. The combination of the subject's grizzled face, slightly smiling expression, the hand to the face as he reaches for the cigarette, and the darker colors of furry head above and top below contrasting with the skin work well. The only criticism, and it's a minor one, is that it would be nice to see a bolder range of light to dark contrast.
The image is by Dave Chiborik. Trapper Dave, 22 points.
Mark has this to say. It's taking me a while to critique this image. I'm not sure how I want to view this or how the photographer wants me to view this image. I see an old man with long hair and a beard. Kind of sounds like somebody I know. Is the old man sad? Is he depressed? Or is he just looking that way because the photographer asked him to? In the image, he is just kind of slumped over and he's not sitting up proud. He's not saying, here I am, taking my picture. He's deep in thought about something. Maybe it's his family. He's wondering what his kids are doing. Maybe he lost his wife in the last year. These are questions that the photographer has brought up in my mind. I say all that to say this, a good image provokes an emotion in the viewer. It could be mad, happy, sad, but it has to create an emotion. The photographer did that very well here. If I had to change something in the image, I might put him in a different shirt that would say a lot about his character and who this man is. Also, I think I would have used a different background. The out-of-focus Muslim-type background interferes with the hair and the beard. I would rather just see a black background or something less with less character to it. The photographer did a wonderful job in creating this thought-provoking image.
The image is by Margaret Brady. It's entitled World Weary, 24 points, third place.
Ray says, I like the use of black and white here. The composition is done very well as the lighting. The lighting helps the photo a lot.
The image is by Darla Zajac. It's entitled Chinese Acrobats, a Balancing Act, 21 points.
Wendy says, if there's a prize for timeliness, this just might win. This unconventional approach to masking up in a store to stock up on toilet paper brings to mind a performance piece and left me wondering if that was the photographer's purpose. Whether that's the case or not, I feel this image would benefit from a tighter crop on the left side and bottom.
The image is by D. Riley. It's entitled Coronavirus Apparel, 21 points.
Mark says, I would call this an environmental portrait. Although the dancer is not in a dance studio or on a stage, this is the environment in which she decided to dance. I do like the fact that it is relatively focused all the way through the image. The dancer is sharp, and the environment around her is just as sharp, is just sharp enough to identify where she's at. I think I would have waited for a different pose in her dance to take the picture. In the image, it seems that she's going down with her arms. It seems to be the end of the move rather than just the beginning of it. If her arms were going up, it would be a grandier move and a more powerful feeling for the image. One thing you want to create in your image is an emotion, something that you want the viewer to take with them after they've seen your photo. I can guarantee that everybody who walked past this dancer on the street saw this dancer from the same view that the photographer did. Create a different point of view of her, whether it's from a higher point or if you just sit down on the street and shoot up at her. That would give the dance a more powerful feel. The image would be stronger. I do not see the need for the vignette on the bottom of the two corners. These seem to be distracting to me.
The image is by Betsy Janda. It is entitled Dancing on East 4th, 25 points, second place.
Ray says, very nice framing. Love the color and the handling of the foreground. Ballerina is sharp and caught in the air at the right time.
The image is by Jackie Sieski. It's entitled Dancing Through the Garden, 24 points, third place.
Wendy says, this head-on portrait is simple and conventional, but does what it does quite well. The subject boldly engages the viewer with a beautifully lit face and wide, expressive eyes. I would prefer it to be a bit less centered, but the drop of the shoulder on the right provides a nice offset to the symmetry, as does the brighter lighting on the left.
The image is by Rick Carell. It is entitled Emma Wren. 25 points, second place.
Mark says, what a fun and well thought out image. This picture took some planning. You just don't come out on the beach and get a picture of a girl jumping doing the splits. This is well planning out. I would love to see a different light, maybe first thing in the morning or late at night, so there is some drama in the sky or in the sunset, because that is the image, that is in the image. The sky is a big part of what's happening. You could try some high-speed sync flash photography. I do like that the photographer captured her right at the peak of her jump and that the lake is level. I don't think the two seagulls in the image and to add to the image.
The image is by Elda Baroni. It's entitled Flying in the Air, 22 points.
Ray says, very well done. Timing was spot on. Glad the background is blurred, yet the girl is still sharp in the movement. Nice rim light on the subject.
The image is by Susan Bestel. It's entitled Hair Flip Splash. 25 points, second place.
Wendy says, the composition is solid and the contrast between the darkness in the room and the brightness outside is nice. The majority of the image is very dark, though. That, combined with the view from behind that hides the subject's face, keeps this image from engaging the viewer more.
The image is by Kim Wasileski. It's entitled, I Am Enough, 21 points.
Mark says, I love images that just saturated the character from the environment that this picture was taken to his hairstyle, clothing, hat expression. All this adds to the character of the image. From a technical point of view, I think I would have cropped off more of the hat or left more of the hat in the image. Shooting somewhere in the middle doesn't add or subtract to the image. So I think I would have lowered my camera and got more of the bottom of the more at the bottom of the picture. I might even turn this into a vertical picture and captured the top of his hat and the bottom of his hair. The exposure is incredibly good, has incredibly good detail in the white beard. You've got detail in his eyes and skin. The only thing in the image that bothers me, and I'm not sure what I'm looking at. So I'm not sure whether I should be bothered or not. The two pieces of hair or dreadlocks don't seem to be in focus. I'm not sure why that is. The environment behind him is focused, so I'm not sure what it says. Maybe it's just how it came across on the camera. But with that said, the photographer did a wonderful job capturing this image.
The image is by Mike Kopkus. It's called Key West Street Musician, 24 points, third place.
Ray says, I really wanted to turn this one upside down to see the face in the center right side up. A lot of things to look at here, and the one thing that I kept on looking at was the upside down face.
The image is by Bonnie Luxo. It's called Lego Heads Rolling, 18 points.
Wendy says, this baby is caught at the perfect time, finger hooked into the lip like he's considering something. Expressive and well cropped. I would prefer sharper detail a bit farther back in the image, like shoulders and ears.
The image is by Bill Keaton. It's entitled Pensive Layla, 22 points.
Mark says, the photographer caught this little girl in very deep thought. What I take away from this image, what does a child who is so young have to be so deep in thought about? I do like the composition of the triangles that formed with the elbow and the arm. My eye keeps running around the picture and keep you centered on the subject. I am thinking the photographer had very little time to capture this image, but I find really harsh light on her face and the lack of detail in the hair changes the mood of the picture. I realize I sound like a Monday morning photographer here, but maybe you could have gone outside and just put up a diffuser between the light and the child. That would have softened those highlights. And then you could bring detail up in the light room with a shadow slider. The image has to be a softer lighting to match the mood of the image.
The image is by Kavitha Subramanian. It's entitled Radiance, 20 points.
Ray says, a very good baby portrait. Nice soft lighting, great pose, and what a storytelling image. Any parent would love this of their child.
The image is by Deb Zimmerman. It's entitled Vintage Alex, 22 points.
Wendy says, this image has a nice composition and balance. The range of tones reads rather flat, though. It would benefit from more light and contrast.
Images by Robert Boyle. It's entitled Waiting by the Window. 23 points, honorable mention. And that concludes our people portion of our competition. We'll move now into the pictorial portion, and only a portion of these images will be commented upon as chosen by the photographer. So the first images will not have comments. We'll leave the image on the screen for a period and then read the scores. The first image is by Dennis Wirt. It is entitled 1936 Packard, 23 points. Second image is by Vicky Wirt. Allspice Fairy Lights, 25 points, second place. Ronald Posner, At the Bund in the Rain in Shanghai, 21 points. Donna Schneider, Battery Point Lighthouse, 24 points, third place. John Harford, Bend in the Road, 22 points. Robert Boyle, Berea Falls, 21 points. Tammy Yankovic, Bermuda Sunrise, 21 points. Dan Hennessy, Budapest Chain Bridge, 20 points. Ron Werman, Cleveland Skyline Reflection, 24 points, third place. John Harford, Dragon Finger, 25 points, second place. Kavitha Subramanian, Drenched in Rain, 21 points. Ron Werman, Entering Union Terminal, 22 points. Wayne Feuerstein, From Darkness to Light, 22 points. Mike Kopkis, Lens Distortion, 23 points. Laura Goyans, Liquid Sunshine, 23 points. Rick Carell, Maple Side Sky 1, 24 points, third place. John Dierba, Mount Rainier Reflections, 24 points, third place. Bonnie Luxo, Musical Window, 22 points. Vicky Wirt, Nautilus Bubbles, 26 points, first place. Jackie Sieski, Ninja Through Prism Glass, 24 points, third place. Ronald Posner, Northwest China Countryside, 23 points. Joseph Miko, Pelican Takeoff, 23 points. Betsy Janda, Playing in Traffic, 21 points. Wayne Feuerstein, Rainy Ireland Through a Car Window, 22 points. Belinda Prinz, Rock Hall in Pink, 23 points. Rick Mills, Rock in Route, 24 points, third place. Rich Foley, Serenity, 21 points. Dan Hennessy, Spider and His Shadow, 19 points. Laura Goyens, Star Trails and Fireflies, 21 points. Kim Wasileski, Stillness, 21 points. Sue Marquard, Stone Garden Law Office, 23 points. Susan Bestel, Sunset Dancer, 24 points, third place. Rich Foley, Sunset Silhouette, 24 points, third place. Joseph Miko, Teasel, 23 points. Darla Zajac, The Amish Gentleman and His Bike, 24 points, third place. Bill Keaton, The Feel of Water, 25 points, second place. Bob Kowaleski, The Picnic Table, 20 points. Rick Mills, Tree with a Foothold, 22 points. Elda Baroni, Trotting in the Woods, 20 points. Ronald Wilson, Tube Light 2, 21 points. Donna Schneider, Vancouver Island Sunset, 22 points. Bonnie Luxo, View from Heidelberg Castle, 21 points. Bob Kowaleski, Yellow, 21 points. The remainder of the images will be commented upon by the judges.
Mark says, I'm sitting here trying to figure out this image. I love the window and the light coming through it. I think the pulley is cool, and of course I love flag and mom and apple pie. Oh wait, that's another story. I'm trying to figure out what all these items, all three items, including the old barn board, have to do with each other. I can put the flag and the window together, but the pulley doesn't fit visually with the window and the flag. So I would need to find a way to eliminate the pulley and center my image on the window and the flag. If the pulley could come off the wall, that would be good. This is a really good example of working the image and what it takes to make a great image. Try to shoot your image like somebody else, like nobody else ever has. Remember that there are always two people in every image, according to Ansel Adams, the photographer and the viewer. When you're working an image, put yourself in the shoes of the viewer and try to envision what they're going to take away from your image. In reworking the image, I think you would leave a bit more of the window. I'd like to see the upper right-hand corner of the window and maybe turn the image slightly to make the window look vertical and not crooked.
The image is by Margaret Brady. It's entitled A Scene from the Past, 23 points.
Ray says, nice lighting and selected focus done here. Nice light to separate the hat from the background. I wish I could see more in the photo. To me, I felt he was closed in.
Images by Richard Ader. It's entitled Amish Blacksmith. 23 points.
Wendy says, the Birch Alley at Stan Hewitt is an inviting subject. Capturing a lone walker beneath an umbrella at the far end of the alley definitely adds interest that helps it go beyond cliche.
Ron Werman, Birch Tree Alley, 22 points.
This is what Mark has to say. And the adventure begins. I can hear the noise of the burner that it makes firing up these big balloons. There is an emotion, the feeling that you can bring away from just viewing one image. The anticipation of watching this happen, the color in the balloons is all part of the image. I like that it is on an angle and not straight up and down. I would have moved the camera over to the left just a bit to include the full circle of dark brown area of the balloon. I'm going to go out on a limb here and probably did not score very high, and the reason that would be a common, the judges have seen this before. But don't let that discourage you. This image is wonderful based on everything that I said at the beginning of this critique. Keep up the good work.
Images by Dave Chiborek. It's entitled Creating Lift. And contrary to Mark's comments, it scored 24 points and earned third place.
Ray says, very nice composition and such an unusual photograph. A very different technique. Makes the viewer think what is done here to get the image.
Images by Tammy Yankovic. It is entitled Crystal Ball Capture. 24 points, third place.
Wendy says, this is a nice capture of great blue herons at their rookery. The birds stand out nicely against the sky and are caught in action, several with wings spread. While it is interesting to have several birds together in the shot, the many branches eat up a lot of the space, and I wonder if it would be a more powerful image if it was cropped down to show focus on just one or two birds.
Belinda Prinz, Heron Hangout, 24 points, third place.
Mark says, stunning image. The curves, the lines, the diagonal shape of the subject all contribute to create a very visually pleasing image. The exposure is very good. The focus is tack sharp. And to top it off, all the photographer created a liquid texture to the image that ties it all together. Well done.
Vicky Wirt, Iced Canna Lily, 25 points. Second place.
Ray says, very nice image here. I love the lighting, composition, focus, and color. A very good pictorial image. I will let the photo speak for itself.
Wayne Feuerstein, Lucky After a Storm, 24 points, third place.
Wendy says, the sweeping landscape is beautiful. The image is nicely balanced, dramatic, and rich. While it doesn't cover any new ground, it offers proof that sometimes a traditional landscape is mighty fulfilling when done right.
Joseph Miko, Matapalo Beach, 24 points, third place.
Mark says, this looks like a mid-November or a late March kind of image. It doesn't have all the impact of beautiful snowfall blanketing the banks of the river in the branches of the trees, but there is a feel and an emotion to this image. Maybe the photographer is longing for summer days when he played in this creek as a kid. I think the photographer shot it from a perfect location. He's got a slight curve in the creek house and the reflection of the house in the water, which is an element of detail to the image. The exposure is good. There is detail in everything. I think that I will try to change them right hand corner. You got a branch of snow sticking out into the creek. I would somehow get rid of the work around it or Photoshop it out.
Images by Bob Kowaleski. North House, 22 points.
Ray says, looks like Tuscany. Beautiful lighting and color in this pictorial. Photographer has good composition, but if there was a little bit more of the road on the left, so would not be cut off.
Dennis Wirt, Pienza Countryside, 23 points.
Wendy says, this lighthouse landscape captures a wonderfully colorful sky. It's a pleasant image, but could benefit from a tighter crop all the way around, especially the bottom and left side, to give the lighthouse greater prominence.
Donna Schneider, Point Arena Sunset, 24 points, third place.
Mark says, this image has all the excitement and feel of barrel racing. The exposure is good, focus is almost there, the hooves are slightly blurry, but the horse's eye is sharp, and that's what counts. In an action shot like this, you need to make sure that your subject has plenty of room to move into the image. Next time, try moving all the way over to your right if possible. Put in the room basically in the center of the image. Let that horse just come right out and around the corner. That creates action, and it gives you the horse and the rider some place to go.
Ronald Wilson, Racer 4, 24 points, third place.
Ray says, nice image. I think the only thing I would do differently is to add a little bit more pop in the printing to bring out the richness just a little.
John D'Ierba, Reflection Lake Sunrise, 22 points.
Wendy says, this piece is nicely detailed and captures the unusual path of a tree root. It reads a bit flat though. It leaves me wanting a closer view with more detail.
Rick Mills, Rock and Root, 22 points.
Mark says, well, he certainly didn't have toys like that when I was a kid. We had the old metal slides that removed several layers of skin off the back of your legs in mid-July. And yes, we loved it. But I regress. This picture is interesting, but is basically a snapshot of a really cool toy that kids get to play on. But don't despair. I see tons of images here. Come back early in the morning issue to sunrise. Do you want the holes? Or go back in the evening. I see taking a group of friends over there with flashlights and setting up a camera on a tripod and having the poker flashlight to Aubrey's Hall and do some light painting with light on this. Poker face through one of the holes, shine a flashlight on and create an exposure that may actually you could do that all by yourself and have six exposures of your face all over the place. These are fun things to do with the camera. Meanwhile, you're learning exposure and composition, focusing, and just how to have fun with the camera. This is a completely empty palette for you to take your camera. Have fun.
Images by Dan Hennessy. It's entitled Spider Web, 20 points.
Ray says, very nice lighting, color, and composition. The rocks in the foreground just lead you into the photo. Very well done. Love the printing of the image.
Richard Schneider, Sunset at Hidden Valley, 22 points.
Wendy says, I love bird shots, and this captures the swimming cormorant nicely as it's reflected in the water. My only issue with this work, though, is in an effort to capture the bird's wake, a bit too much empty space has been left. Personally, I think that tightening the image a bit, especially on the right, would make it even better.
John Harford, Swimming Cormorant, 22 points.
Mark says, When this image came up on the screen, I literally had to just sit back and take it in for a few minutes. There are so many good things about this compositionally. Great reflection, you've got angles, you've got circles, you've got triangles. One of the neatest triangles is between the three lights on the posts. Your eye goes from the left and then back to the right without ever leaving the image. Then you've got the fact that this is in black and white and probably at least 10 shades of everything in between. There's nothing dull or muddy about this image. Even tone has a reason for being there. Ansel Adams and his zone theory or system would be very proud of this image.
Images by Omar Jeffries, the Performing Arts Hall, 25 points, second place.
Ray says, nice image here. I like how you have the open sky over the image of the tree. I think I would have moved the cropping so the tree was not so to the center, off to the right more.
Ronald Posner, Tree at Bryce Canyon, 22 points.
Wendy says, a lovely shot of a white-throated sparrow. The expression, angle, and details captured in the head and chest are especially nice. While the scattered seeds on the deck rail give it a bit of messiness and a very different feel from a shot taken in a field, the sharp details of the bird's head right down to the seeds on his beak are really the focal point of the image. The contrast of the sharp, largely dark-colored head and body against the softer, paler backgrounds works well. You could possibly go in a bit tighter, especially on the bottom.
Sue Marquardt, White-Throated Sparrow, 22 points. And that concludes our competition for this evening. Thanks to everyone who entered, and congratulations to all of our winners. We appreciate you spending your Friday evening with us, and we'd appreciate your feedback. We know we still have some technical hurdles we have to overcome, but we're doing our best as we can and hope to get better and better each and every week. Please let us know how we're doing. Send us your feedback via email at info@clevelandphoto.org. So that concludes this evening. Please join us next Friday at 7:30. Our own Coleman Rosenberg will be here to discuss the topic of impact. Thanks again. See you next week.